Martinson. Oh, his feet turned over off a leg. Here's a shot. Good save by Ward. A great look for Blaze, and Ward beat him point blank.
And then Seabrook roughs up O'Reilly, but Maroon gets it free. Great pass, Parayko. In front, shot. He scores! Parayko! A power play goal! He crushed it!
Well, Colton Parayko had a chance to fire one just before that. He said he played it to Ryan O'Reilly to his left. This time, no mistake whatsoever. The goaltender's going to come out. You can see that Anisimov comes out. I don't think it glanced off his stick, but might have made it more difficult, and it had some heat on it as well.
Henry Jokiharju, a 19-year-old, and a pad saved by Jake Allen. Here come the Hawks to break it, and Jake Allen dives! Kept in a drive, and a save on Duncan Keith by Allen. It was Scramble City back to the goal for Jake Allen. Try to tuck it under the pad of Ward. And blocked down by O'Reilly.
What a hit
to Tarasenko. Wide open in front. He scores! Tarasenko!
What a hit by Patty Maroon as he and big Brent Seabrook, two number sevens, go at it. And then Maroon, before that, in all alone right there on a nice little forehand back. And watch number seven come in. This is his check right there. That allows the interception to be made. Seabrook down. Maroon goes to the front of the net. And the Blues end up scoring with Tarasenko red hot against the Chicago Blackhawks. The shot squirts through the legs, off the leg, and into the net on the short side.
Now the Hawks get it in. Here's to bring it to the late man, Gustafson. He got rid of that one. The rebound, they score! A hot bounce from the end boards of the captain right there. Jonathan Toews able to cut the St. Louis lead in half.
Amazing when you get to the front of the net. Gustafson gets his puck, Pat. It gets deflected, but Toews goes to the front of the net and beats Jake Allen. That is a huge response. But Gustafson got rid of it, even though it got deflected, and then Toews avoids Petrangelo. And the Hawks answer back. That is a gigantic goal.
And he missed Kane with a pass attempt on a turnaround effort. Now it's Kane, waiting, wiring. He scores! Patrick Kane, tremendous patience, picked his spot. Found it. We're tied at two.
Boy, circle the wagons. Net front presence, I believe, by Brandon Saad, standing right in front of Jake Allen. And Allen never saw it. And Kaner goes top shelf. Time and space. And from about 40 feet out, the quick little wrister from 88, and twos are wild here in a second.
Play by Seabrook. The Blues had something going. If that pass connects, it didn't. Kane on the counterattack, driving and shooting. Tight rebound, they score! A tap in for Marcus Kruger. A huge play defensively by Brent Seabrook leads to an odd man rush the other way. Kruger from Kane, 3-2 Chicago.
Well, there's that defensive play you talked about, Pat. The stick by Seabrook. Schmaltz gets it up to the neutral zone. Kane with the quick shot, and Kruger, who was fresh off the bench. Finds it in the back of the empty net. And it's a 3-2 lead for the Hawks.
In front, Maroon. Back door! Tarasenko!
Oh, no!
What a save by Ward!
Did he get a stick on that?
Unbelievable save! Another shot by Bozak! And a save by Ward again! And it's under Tyler Bozak. Maroon gets it free. And now back for Dunn. And it's buzzing in here. The Blues can't believe they didn't score. To the line now to Tarasenko. He fakes it and works in a shot off the arm of Ward. And we get the horn. Darren, they might review this, and they obviously will, as Ward got a stick on the shot by Tarasenko.
Well, very similar to the play that Robert Thomas made against the Winnipeg Jets, but upon further review, Toronto saw that, waves the horn. The fans are on their feet because they see it on the beautiful Jumbotron here. And although Cam Ward made a valiant, brilliant effort to knock it out of midair, it is going to be a goal in the game-tying goal. You can see the maroon backhand pass is outstanding. Tarasenko's shot. Look at that. Across the goal line, and it's in the net. There it is, clearly there. So Toronto doesn't waste anybody's time right there. They see the puck is conclusive. They call it down.
Barbashev gets free. Now handed back to Schwartz in front of Barbashev. He missed it. And then Butler, the drive. He scores! The Butler has done it! And the Blues have taken a 4-3 lead!
Well, this line tweaking by Mike Yeo and Craig Berube has paid dividends, and the Blues have changed the momentum of this game around. Two St. Louis-born boys making a big difference in the third period. Patty Maroon, and now on the left side of your screen is number 25, Chris Butler. A C&I shot through traffic and over the shoulder of the goaltender. Amazing look right there under the bar and in, a perfect shot from Butler.
Back comes to break it. Dropped it, shot Joakim Harju, the rebound, and the score! Jonathan Toews, after Joakim Harju got it to the net, the rebound available, and Toews, under duress, able to tie things up at four.
Well, how about the save at the other end from Cam Ward, and then this puck is like a pinball machine. And how often do we talk about it, partner? You want to score goals, you got to get to the front of the net. And the puck finds the captain. And it bounces in, I think, off Alex Pietrangelo and goes top shelf from Toews. And a huge response by the captain. And this game is tied up at four.
Three goals in the first six periods of the year. Smothered by Saad, and a breakaway for Toews. He's in alone. Front center ice to win it. Hawks win! Hawks win! A hat trick for Jonathan Toews. After a shot block at one end, leads to a breakaway at another. Hawks, who trailed 2-0 in the game, have won it in OT 5-4.
Well, Henry Joakim Harju does a great job on Vladimir Tarasenko. Prevents him from getting any kind of a shot. And Brandon Saad with the shot block, and Toews from the far blue line in goes right over the glove of Jake Allen. And hats rain on the ice here in St. Louis.